We love that new album, fellows. This last quoted example didn't go down too well, however, when we tried it out recently in Liverpool with the Lars. Why, you ask? Because the Lars can't stand their first album. They can't abide their record label, and they positively detest their producer, the very famous Steve Lillywhite. What more can you say about those restless youths, apart from mentioning that they are Liverpool bad boys with more bite to their beat than you can shake a stick at? On Rapido, then, all the way from Liverpool, from the Lars, Opportunity Knox.
Don't expect the Lars to be any more enthusiastic about Liverpool than they seem to be about anything else.
Does mean much to come from here. We are proud of it. But like, I mean, you get all this crap about, like, you know, the Beatles, four lads from Liverpool and all this, and we get, like, tagged with that and Mersey beat, and it seems to us like people do want to, like, get this Mersey thing going, like, kind of thing from outside, which can't be a bad thing for the city, like. It seems to us like people do have that attitude about, like, there is something coming from Liverpool. You know what I mean? And we'll go with that. Let me tell
So lead singer and songwriter Lee Mavers and bass guitarist John Power have been fronting various lineups of the Lars since 1986. It was only last year that their record company Go Disc finally released their first album, simply called The Lars. Unfortunately, the band don't like that either.
Shadow, like, for instance, they weren't like their proper performances. They were just like, we were messing around in the studio, fiddling around with sounds and not happy playing tongue in cheek. And that's the state that all the recording was up to by the time we left. We jibbed it at about 3 months into it, like, because it was still no better since day one. And somehow, they've even got voices where there wasn't voices and mixed that up as well. So, you know, but still, like, you know, I am embarrassed about this thing, and it's terrible, like, you know what I mean? It's a croak. It's non-musical, and, you know, I think the record's non-rhythmical or anything. It's just, it's a mess, like.
Have battled with modern recording techniques over the last 3 years, trying to capture their authentic garage sound.
Our sound, which we've already got, you know, which is very acoustic bass, but more organic kind of sounds than, say, like, the usual sounds of today. You know what I mean? It's hard to capture in a modern studio, which is geared up to DI and, like, synthesizers and the rest of it. Well, geared up to that nowadays.
More of a beat group than a dance act, with the emphasis on good old songs instead of just a sound, the Lars feel that there's nothing particularly novel about what they do.
Well, we play guitars and, like, put together in a four-piece band that's just, like, guitars and drums. It's the same format, and it's just garage band kind of stuff, innit?
It's all been done before, hasn't it, like?
Yeah. You know.
It's all about the 60s. It's before that as well, Nick. Like.
That's right.
There's a lot forgotten about, Nick. Like. It all stops at the 60s.
In 1987, the Lars were tipped as the new Smiths. 3 years of back-breaking work has only resulted in a few singles and an album which the Lars hate. Lee Mavers is understandably frustrated with their slow progress.
It's not just about playing music, which is, that's what we thought it would be like, you know, just as simple as playing music and just recording dead simple, you know, the way we had done in the past. But there's more to it, there's more business, more red tape, more kooks spoiling the broth, being told what to do, you got to do it a certain way or it doesn't go, and a lot of upset, and you got to learn how to deal with that. And it took us a long time, because it is radically different What we want to do is radically different from the way we're being marketed.
Spanish is a loving tongue, Bob Dylan once sang.